Hi, hello, this is Shweta. Welcome to my classes. Today, we will study 7 crystal systems. We will find the short trick for 7 crystal systems. Based upon the edge length and edge angles, 7 type of basic or primitive unit cells have been recognized among crystals. These are called as 7 crystal systems or crystal habits, which today we are going to learn. Before going to the crystal systems, we will study what are axial lengths and axial angles. So axial lengths I am writing, they are represented by A, B and C, and axial angles are represented by alpha, beta and gamma. So A, B, C are nothing but your axial lengths, and axial angles are alpha, beta and gamma. So let me show you that in one cubic structure. So just consider this as a cube. So you will have 3 axes, isn't it? This one axis, this will be 3 dimensional. And here one axis and here one axis. Now I will show you what are the axial lengths. So this, whatever this distance you can see, that is taken as A. And this distance is B. And this distance is C. These are the axial lengths. I am showing you in the diagram. So this distance is taken as axial length A. This distance is taken as axial length B. And this distance is taken as axial length C. Okay. Now let us study what are axial angles. So, the angle opposite to A or between B and C is said to be alpha. Okay, this is axial angle alpha. And the angle opposite to B or between that of C and A is called as beta. And that between opposite to C is said to be gamma. So, how is that structure that is congested? Here once again I will show you. So, these are the 3 axes which are seeing. This is taken as A, this is B and this is C. You can see. And this is alpha, this is beta and this is gamma. These are the axial lengths and axial angles. So once again I am clearing you, this is your axial length A, this is B and this is C, and angle which is opposite to A is said to be alpha, which is between C and B, and angle opposite to B or which is between C and A is said to be beta, and the angle which is opposite to C is said to be gamma, that is between A and B. These are axial lengths and axial angles. Based on these, now there are 7 types of crystal systems. So now one by one with an easy trick we are going to study crystal systems. So here I have written a short trick for remembering the 7 crystal system. What is that trick? It is a bit funny, but you should remember so that it is very easy to write all the crystal system. It is just a statement. I have written cute O mota hero. Cute O mota hero. What is Cu? Cu indicates the cubic. Cu indicates cubic. I have taken the first 2 letters, that is Cu. Okay. Next it is Te. Okay. Te is what? Tetragonal. Te is tetragonal. Again I have taken the first 2 letters of tetragonal. Next is what? O I have taken. O means what? Orthorhombic. O is orthorhombic. So that is only 1 letter. Directly I have taken that orthorhombic. Next is what? Mo. Mo is what? Monoclinic. I have taken again the first 2 letters. Next is monoclinic. Next is T. So you have to consider only T, that is triclinic. Monoclinic, then triclinic. Next is HE. So that stands for hexagonal. And last is what? You are remained with RO, that is rhombohedral. So see, so easy the crystal system is to remember. So that too in order you can remember. If you know this short trick, then easily you can remember all the crystal systems. So how? First 2 letters. This is cute. Okay. This is O. Cute O. This is mota. This is hero. Isn't it? Cute O mota hero. Then this is very easy to remember all these cubic letters. Now how to remember these axial lengths? You know that axial length will be always A, B and C. So in all the crystal system you have A, B, C. But either they are equal or they are not equal, you cannot remember these easily. So instead of by hatting, there is a short trick. This at least you know how to write. Similarly, you write throughout 7 times, you write A equal to B equal to C. Then what you do? First one you need not touch. In first cubic, A equal to B equal to C will be the same. Similarly, last one. Here also A equal to B equal to C will be same. Means what? In cubic and rhombohedral, your axial lengths will be always same. Next in tetragonal, what you do? From back here, one you cancel out. Let this be same. And here also, for hexagonal, last but one you cancel out. Let this be same. Okay, what you did? A equal to B equal to C is same. Here also A equal to B equal to C is same. next one what you did, from last you cancelled one. Here also next one what you did, from last you cancelled one. So next, out of these three, all the three are remaining. So what you do, in all these three, they will not be equal, not be equal, not be equal. Clear? This is a very easy trick to remember. So what you did, just you wrote ABC for all, and then first one and last one you didn't touch, because in both the crystals, it will be symmetrical. So last but one, here also last but one, you are scratching B is not equal to C. And rest three, which are in between, you are scratching all the three. It means what? In cubic system, your edge length, axial lengths are same. Okay, even in rhombohedral it is same. In tetragonal, only A will be equal to B and not equal to C. Similarly in hexagonal. And in orthorhombic, monoclinic and triclinic, all the axial lengths, A is not equal to B is not equal to C. This is the easy way to remember the axial lengths. So here, axial angles I have written. You already studied what are axial angles. They are designated by alpha, beta and gamma. So in first three cases, that is cubic, tetragonal and orthorhombic, what happens? Here all the angles are equal to 90 degrees. This is default. Alpha equal to beta equal to gamma 90, here also 90, 90. All these three axial angles are equal to 90 degrees. So this is completed. Clear? And come to directly last. So in rhombohedral what happens? All the angles are not equal to 90 degrees. What you have to remember? In first three case, all are equal to 90 degrees. In last case, alpha and beta, gamma are equal, but it will not be equal to 90 degrees. These four are clear. Okay. Then come to directly triclinic. In triclinic what happens? It is the most unsymmetrical system. You can see here A is not equal to B is not equal to C. Then definitely here also alpha is not equal to beta is not equal to gamma is not equal to 90 degrees. Means it is most, what you can say, it is most unsymmetrical, this you can say, crystal system you can say. So this is, that directly you can remember, because this is the question asked in many a times. In objective questions they will be asking, which is the most unsymmetrical crystal system. That time you have to answer triclinic. So directly you will get to know, here alpha, beta, gamma are not equal to 90 degrees. And which is the most symmetric means? Cubic. This is also very frequently asked questions in some of the exams. So cubic is most symmetric and triclinic is least symmetric. So directly you got to know, first three will be 90 degree, last one will not be equal to 90 degree, and triclinic means all are not equal to each other and it is not also equal to 90 degree. Now just you are remained with monoclinic and hexagonal. Monoclinic you have to consider alpha and gamma. Last two angles you have to consider. They will be equal to 90 degree and obviously center one will not be equal to 90 degree. And in hexagonal what happens? Alpha beta will be equal to 90 degree and just gamma equal to 180. This in hexagonal system you can easily see. There you can have in hexagonal law, it hexagonal means your up ring system will be like this, isn't it? So one of the angle here it will be of 120 degree. So using that trick you have to remember hexagonal is like 120 degree. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please do share, subscribe and like my channel and tap the bell icon to get notified. Thank you.